My name is Mayank Prasad and I work in MySQL development team from Bangalore, India. And today I'll be talking about MySQL Performance Schema. This is the safe harbor statement. Okay. So here's the end of today's talk. I'll talk about the need and design of performance schema, the instruments and instrumentations, the statistics table behind performance schema. And I'll take the use cases to explain how we can use performance schema to diagnose real-world issues. And then I'll give you a glimpse of what is new in MySQL 8.0 for performance schema. So before we go further, how many of you have used performance schema before? Okay. Right. So the question comes, why do we need performance schema? So there are a lot of MySQL database users. There is an end user who might see why my session is stuck. There might be a MySQL developer like me who is developing source code and he might see why there is a contention in my source code. There might be an application developer who is developing an application and he sees, okay, my application is running source code. So to help these guys and to answer these questions, performance schema comes into the picture. So if you ask me to define performance schema, I will say performance schema is a mechanism to give an insight of what is happening behind the scene when MySQL Server is running. It was introduced in MySQL 5.5 way back. We introduced a new storage engine, which we called Performance Schema. A new database was introduced, Performance Underscore Schema. And the statistics of running MySQL Server are stored in the tables, which are part of this database. These tables have hard-coded DDLs. You are not supposed to modify the structure of the table, and you cannot add table or delete tables. And then we provided SQL user interface as well. So if you want to get the statistics of running MySQL Server, you can simply fire the query, SQL query, and get the data. Important thing is there is no need of application change if you want to use performance schema. Okay, so let me give you a glimpse of bird eye view how the performance schema design looks like. So there are two parts in performance schema. One is statistics collection, another is statistics reporting. So statistics collection is the part where the server collects the statistics, and the reporting is the part where user wants to see the data and ask for the statistical data. So let's say we have a MySQL server running. In the source code itself, we have instrumentation points. So when the flow comes to these points, the control is transferred to performance schema module. It collects the data and stores the data into performance schema internal buffers. And now if a user like me, suppose I want to get some statistical data out of performance schema, I just pass it to SQL queries to MySQL server, and the query will be executed, data will be fetched from these buffers, and given to the users in performance schema tables. Right? Let's talk about the instruments and instrumentation. So because MySQL server is running, there are a lot of activities happening behind the scene. So to uniquely identify each and every activity which performance schema monitors, we have given them a name. So these names are called instruments. They are like a tree structure. Different components are separated by a forward slash. Let me give you an example. So let's see. These are the two instruments or name of monitored activity. The first one is a wait activity, which is happening on an I/O. This I/O is happening on a file, and the file is MySQL log file. Similarly, the other example is statement. This is a statement, SQL statement. And what kind of SQL statement? It's a select SQL statement. So performance schema is capable of monitoring these activities, right? In 8.0, we have 1200 plus activities or 1200 plus instruments. All these instruments are listed in a table, which is called performance schema setup instruments table. We look at this table in the next slide. Right. So as I said, the activities which we monitor in MySQL performance schema, we list them into in this setup instruments table. There are three main columns: name, enable, and time. Name is the name of the activity. Enable says whether performance schema is collecting at statistics of this activity or not. And time says whether performance schema is collecting the timing information of this activity or not. So the first one is statement SQL select. Enable is here, stand is here. So performance schema is monitoring all the select statements on the server and collecting the timing information of those statements as well. But the second one is create table. The performance schema is collecting statistics, but it is not collecting the timing information of the create table. and create database, when performance schema is not doing anything. This is what we provide performance schema. I mean, we tell performance schema what to collect and how to do it. And the best part is, all these are configured at runtime. So you have the server running, and at runtime you decide, okay, I want to monitor all these activities. You don't have to restart your server. You can just go over there, run an update command on this table, and select whatever activities you want to monitor. Right? Now let's have a look at what a statistics table with performance schema provides. There are a number of tables. I try to categorize them into categories based on how they're used. So this is a set of tables. These are the tables using which we tell performance schema what to collect and how to collect. Like a set of instruments table, which is on the previous slide. We have set of actors table. We tell for what users we want to collect the statistics for. Set of objects table, what are objects we want to collect the statistics for, like which table, right? Then we have tables. For different events which are happening on the server, like transactions, statements, stages, weights, and idle event, and errors. I will explain all of them in the future slides. Then we have instances tables, all the mutexes we have in MySQL Server code, the read write logs we have, number of files which we are using in MySQL Server. Then we have log tables for metadata logs, table logs, and we have data logs table as well, which is added in 8.0. We have connection attributes, the type of connection, then tables for application summary. So previously we used to do the show slave status to get the status of the application, right? All those information has been ported to performance schema in 5.7 itself. Then we have tables for system and session variables. A new table is added in variable info in 8.0 that I will talk about. And apart from that, we have miscellaneous tables like threads, tables, and all. Apart from this, these are the statistics collected. Performance schema also aggregate the statistics and give you a very good consolidated output of those statistics based on different factors. So we have summary tables of events. These events are nothing but transition state to stage. We have summary tables of memory, IOs, connections, and all these summary tables are categorized by different factors like summary by global, somebody by a specific user, somebody by a specific host, or by a specific session, and by digest. Now let's take a use case to see how we can use MySQL Performance Schema to diagnose real world issues. Before we go into use case, let me give you a glimpse what information you can get from Performance Schema. So let's say I ran this query, update Performance Schema setup instrument, set enable is equal to yes, and time is equal to yes. So what I'm doing here is I'm telling you, okay, Performance Schema, you collect everything. All the activities and collect timing information also for all the activities. Let's say I have two sessions, session 1 and session 2. In session 1, I did 3 insert statements and then I did a select star. In session 2, I did 2 insert statements and a commit. That's it. Before we go to the next slide, just keep in mind there are 3 insert statements in session 1, 2 insert statements in session 2. The last statement is select star in session 1, and last statement is commit in the session 2. Right? So this is all, that's all happening on the server as of now. Let's go to performance schema and see what it can give us. So performance schema has a table called event statement current table, which gives us information of the current statement being executed or the last statement executed by a thread. So if I look at this table, I see, okay, the thread V24 has executed the select statement and this is the text of that statement. Similarly, thread V25 has executed a commit statement. So with this table, we can see all the last statement executed by any thread on the server. Okay, so I got the last statement. How about if I want to see the consolidation by session or by thread? So we have a table called event statement summary by thread, which gives a summary of the statement executed by a specific session. So we see the first session has executed 3 insert statement, and the second session has executed 2 insert statement. So we got the last statement, we got the statement by thread ID. Now how about at the global level? Doesn't matter from which thread the statements are coming from. So we have this event statement global summary global, where we can see, okay, there are 5 insert statements executed as of now on the server and 5 commit statements executed on the server. Right? So that's a glimpse what we can get from performance schema. Now let's take a few use cases. So let's say server is running and there are a lot of activities happening on the server, a lot of queries are executing. We want to find out the long running query. So can performance schema help here? So let's say X is a threshold, so anything goes beyond X, or any query take time more than X, we say that's a longer query. So we have this event statement history table. So the current table is the one which gives you the last statement. The history table gives you the historical data of a thread. So let's say you give me all the statements which are taking time more than X. So performance schema used in this information says, okay, now there is a select statement with a text like this. This is the guy who is taking time more than X. And if I go further, I see okay, select scan is equal to 1. And no index used this one. So for this select statement, it has to be full table scan. And there's no index used for that. So if at all I could introduce an index which would be used in this select statement, I might be able to perform this query. But let's take another use case. So we have server running, which has a lot of queries running. And I see the event statement summary by digest. These are the statements which are being executed, and these statements are executed 1725 times. And for all of them, it has resulted into an error. So this is the statement which we have to look into. And the first time the statement was seen is this timestamp, and the last time the statement was seen is by timestamp. Right? Let's go to the third use case. So let's say I am the MySQL developer, I am developing MySQL source code. And in my source code, I see there is a section thread T1 which is not moving, stuck. Can performance schema come help me in this scenario? So I said we have event statement current table, right, which gives me the current statement executed. Similarly, we have events weights current table in performance schema, which tells me the weights events which are being executed on the server. So I say, okay, now give me the weights events, the current weights event, for thread ID to T1, because T1 is the one which has been stuck. So I get this. That T1 is waiting for a mutex A. Now thread T1 is waiting for a mutex A and is not able to proceed, that means somebody else is holding mutex A, right? Now I go to the mutex instances table and ask, okay, now who is the guy who is holding mutex A? So from this table, I come to know, okay, there is a thread T2 which is holding mutex A. Now thread T2 is holding mutex A and not releasing it. That means thread T2 is also waiting for something. So I go further with the same table, event weights current, and this time I ask about T2 and so on. So I can keep on going like this, and finally I can find out the culprit, who is the guy who is making everybody wait in this chain. Right? Okay, so event hierarchy. So performance schema maintains the event hierarchy. What are the events? So when a session is connected to the server, it might execute multiple transactions. So all those transactions belong to that session. In a transaction, there would be multiple statements. And in a statement, when it is executed, it goes through multiple stages. The stages could be parsing the query, optimizing the query, opening tables, fetching data, right? And every stage has multiple waits event. So when you say opening tables, it might go through a wait for to get the log on the table. So this hierarchy is maintained in performance schema. I will give you a glimpse how this is maintained. So as I said, transaction have multiple statements. Statements have multiple stages have multiple weights events. So all these are the events which are happening on the server. To uniquely identify these events, we have given them a specific ID. That is called event ID. These event IDs are unique for every transaction or stage or wait. Apart from this event ID, there is something called nesting event ID. So the nesting event ID of waits events which are coming from a specific stage events points to the event ID of that stage event. Similarly, all the stage events which are coming from a specific statement will have nesting event ID pointing to the event ID of that statement. And similarly, all the statements which are coming from a specific transaction will have the nesting event ID of the transaction. Right? So with this hierarchy, we can take the very low level weights events and we can trace it back to the transaction from which transaction this weight is coming from. Okay, now let's see what's new we have in MySQL 8.0. So in MySQL 8.0, we added a lot of instruments. We added instrumentation for errors, we added instrumentation for variable information, we added instrumentation for data logs, weights, we added instrumentation for statement histograms, and we added instrumentation for we added new feature like plugin component table service. We had the enhancements as well. We have indexes in performance schema tables now, statement histogram. We have digest for a sample. I will look into these. Let's talk about the error instrumentation first. So if at all any error comes on the server and if this instrumentation is enabled, performance schema collect the status for that error. This error could have been handled error or not handled error. And again, they are summarized based on the user, from which user how many errors are coming, from which session the error is coming. Let's take an example to see. Let's say there are two connections. The first guy did a select star from a non-existing table. The second guy did a try to use a database which does not exist and try to select from the table which does not exist. So there are three notable does not even exist error. There is one database does not exist error. And let's see how the performance schema can give this information. So we have this events error summary by thread. So we see the thread ID 46 has two does not exist table error. Thread number 47 has one does not exist table error and 47 has one bad database error. So this is by thread. Now let's see at the global level. It says, okay, on the server, till now, there are three table does not exist error and one database does not exist error. So there's a new table added, variable info. So with the help of this table, we can see which variable has been set by whom and in what time the variable has been set and what is the source of that variable. Is it a compile time default value or is it a persistent value or explicitly set by the user or it has been set from the command line? Right, so let's see an example. So here we have this variable name max connection. If you get the information from the variable info table, we see the variable source is compiled, so it has a compile time default value. The minimum value of this variable is this, max value is this, and null for set user because nobody has set this variable. As much as compile time default. Now I will try to set this variable and will it persist. So the restart this variable will exist here. And now I try to query this table, then I see, okay, this variable source is persisted, so this is a persisted variable. This is the file from where the variable function has been taken from. This is the guy who has set this variable. And this is a timestamp when this variable was set. Now we have indexes and performance schema tables in 8.0. So earlier, when you do a select star from or you ask for a specific row from performance schema used to return all the data, all the rows to the upper layer. And then upper layer used to do the filtering. With this feature, performance schema itself does the filtering and return on the specific row to the upper layer. It improved the performance of performance schema query. Let's see example how it does that. Okay, so let's say we are querying for this variable name from this variable by thread table. I'm just saying ignore index. So indexes have been ignored here. Now I try to look at handler's API execution. So I see this handler read random next API has been called 291 times. So this API is the API which is called to get a data from the storage engine layer. So in this particular example, 291 times it has been called. So it is asking the row for performance key or performance key returning all the rows and then it filter out one row and it display it here. Now let's modify this example. In this time I'm using index. And if I see the handler statistics, I see that a handler read next has not been called in once. And only one time the row is filtered and passed by performance schema to the upper layer. Okay, now we have data logs tables also added in performance schema. So let's say transaction A is locking a row R and transaction B also intends to lock the same row. So B is effectively blocked by the transaction A, right? So this table gives me which data has been locked, who has locked this table, and who has locked this data, and who is waiting for this data. Let's take an example. This is the guy who has done select star for table for update. So all the rows on the table have been locked. If I see the monitoring session, I see the thread ID 51 has requested an exclusive lock on the record and it has been granted. Now the session 2, he tries to get the rows from the table, but because they have been locked by this particular guy, it goes for a wait. And if I see monitoring session, performance schema session, I see that thread that is typically do is waiting for a record log. The same record log has been granted to this thread. Right? And then we have a statement histogram which has been added to 8.0 also. So earlier we had from this, let's say, from statement digest theorem, we can see the minimum, the statement which was taking the minimum time, the statement which was taking the maximum time, and the average time. With the help of this guy, we have defined specific buckets of the latency, and the statement which is taking a specific time falls into a specific bucket. Let me give an example. So this is event statement histogram by digest. So these two digests are same. So these are the same type of statements, but its bucket timer low is this. Bucket number 116 and bucket number 112, the timer low is this and timer high is this. So this is the minimum and maximum timestamp for the bucket. And there's a bucket quantile, which is 0.4, either 1.0. So what does it mean? It's saying that 40% of the statement of this digest falls into this bucket and has been executed with a latency lower than this time. And here the quantile is 100, so 100% of the queries of this digest have been executed timing less than this particular. And apart from that, we have we already have this table event statement summary by digest. There are three new columns added to this table, quantile 95, 99, and 999. So it says 95% of the time the query was executed less than this particular timing. This is 99%, and again this is 99.9% of the time this query has been executed less than this particular time. Then we have this plugin and component table service. So as I said, performance schema tables, you are not supposed to modify. You cannot modify the definition. You cannot add your table. There was a request from the community that we want to expose our data using performance schema table. So this feature was implemented. We provided a service, PFS plugin table service. It gives you two methods, add tables and delete top tables. So, right, so using this service, you can add your own table in performance schema and expose your data. And once you are done, you can re-register your table and say, put a new table. So there are two examples implemented, which are shipped with the master server. One is plugin example, one is component example. So PFS example plugin employee is an example of plugin, and the PFS example of component. Just go through these two examples and you can easily know how to add your own table in performance schema. And this is another request from the community, digest query sample. So we have this statement digest summary table. So this has a consolidated summary of all the statements. They wanted to have one sample query in the schedule itself. So we added that. There's a new variable added, performance schema max digest sample age. So the query will be sampled for this particular time. If the time expires, the new query will be sampled. Here's an example. So let's say there's a session, it executed three statements. These three statements are of similar type, so they will have the same digest. And if I see event statement summary by digest table, these three new things are there. Query sample text, so select star from T1 where CL is less than 3. So this query has been sampled, the first query. When was the query seen? And how much time this particular query has taken? Okay, so this is the summary. In 8.0, we have 100 plus tables. We have 1200 plus instruments or activities. We have instruments for IO operations, logs, memory usage, connection types. We have instruments for transaction, statement, stages. We have instruments for stored program, procedures, functions, triggers, events. Instrumentation for global session variables, global session status, summary tables, indexes, and all these summaries are categorized based on users, hosts, accounts, sessions. Okay, apart from that, we have something called sys schema. Sys schema is a collection of procedures, functions, and views. They are the day-to-day things which DBA faces, and we have put them into form of procedures, functions, and views. And these guys will take information from performance schema tables and information schema tables, with the statistical information in very informative way to the user. This has been very well received feature by the community, and they got very good feedback about it. So maybe you guys can go back and look at it, right? Yeah, that's all.
what is the overhead of using this? Second, does it have any self-reporting or self-healing, or is it that something within the pipeline now that you have collated data of what is right, what is wrong, and looking at the statistics and just
first question is, what is the overhead of this? So this is happening at the runtime, so definitely it will have some overhead. So if you enable everything in performance schema, you will see some overhead, that's for sure. So that's why you have to be very careful of what to enable, what not to enable. But by default, we have enabled few of the instruments, and I guess there was a benchmark done on that, and it was noted that 5% with the default instrumentation enabled, there's a performance hit of 5%. What is another question?
Self-reporting and self-healing, because you might have consolidated statistics somewhere that if a parameter is more than this, then it's probably something is wrong.
Okay. So self-healing, self-reporting is, I mean, if I guess the performance schema wants to suggest something, that's what you're saying? Okay. So performance schema does not suggest anything.
Any clues?
I'll tell you. So it collects the statistics, it presents you, okay, this is what the status is. Now you have to use your own heuristic or your own maybe common sense or whatever you want to say, and then you have to decide, take decision based on that. It does not do anything on its own. It just going to give you information what is happening. Third question is, it doesn't have a UI. So MySQL has this MySQL Enterprise Monitor, which uses performance schema at the very low level, and it gives you very good UI of what is happening on the server, the graphs and pie charts and all those things. Those are there. That's an enterprise tool. It's not a tool.
For all the function event, I'm not sure that the CEO of the current one. I mean, it would have the history, right? The historical event view for the session.
I didn't get the question.
Okay, yeah. For the session event, you have showed us the current, right? Current event with. Do we have a history event with? Just like in a local that we have the IT session history.
Let me go back to the top. You're saying columns?
The current session wait.
Oh, current session, okay, right.
Yeah. You want to see the history.
Oh yeah, history is there, right?
The point in time history that in the past, let's say 1 hour, 2 hours for the session.
Okay, no. Okay, point in time history, that is not there. So there is a limited buffer in which performance effect can collect the statistics for. So you have to specify, okay, you want, let's say, historical statement, statistics. So you can say, okay, I want to collect the statistics of last 200 statements, or last 1,000 statements.
So we have to use our own monitoring and that.
Yeah, so we can say, okay, collect the statistics of last 500 statements. But you cannot say, okay, collect the statistics from, give me the statistics from last 2 hours or last 4 hours. You cannot say that. Okay, no more questions. If at all you have any questions, we are at the booth. Master booth is the next area, so we can have a discussion over there as well. Thank you.